What if a wind springs up quite suddenly and casts a green, unripened fruit to earth? Shall we call this a tyrant's act or just? Shall we consider it as right or wrong? If death is just, how can this not be so? Why then lament and wail at what is just? Your soul knows nothing of this mystery. You cannot see what lies beyond this veil. Boy whose face shone like the moon. It seemed he was the Pahlavan Rostam, or that he was the Lion Song, or Nariman. Because he laughed and had a cheerful face, his mother called him by the name Sohrab. Mother Tamine to question her. Tell me the truth, he said. When asked, who is your father, what shall I say? Your father is the Pahlavan Rostam, said Tamine. Since first the world creator made the earth, there's been no other horseman like Rostam. Rostam is the father, I the son. Who else in all the world should wear a crown? Now from among the warlike Turks, I will amass an army boundless as the sea. I'll drive Qaboos from off his throne, and from Iran I'll scour all trace of Tus. To brave Rostam I'll give throne, mace and crown, and seat him in the place of Shah Qaboos. Your workings are. From you comes both what's broken and what's whole as well. Of these two men, neither was stirred by love. Wisdom was far off, the face of love not seen. From fishes in the sea to wild horses on the plain, all beasts can recognize their young. But man, who's blinded by his wretched pride, cannot distinguish son from foe. They firmly hitched their steeds as ill-intentioned fate revolved above their heads. Once more they grappled hand to hand, each seized the other's belt and sought to throw him down. Whenever evil fortune shows its wrath, it makes a block of granite soft as wax. Sohrab had mighty arms, and yet it seemed the skies above had bound them fast. He paused in fear. Rostam stretched out his hand and seized that warlike leopard by his chest and arms. He bent his strong and youthful back, and with a lion's speed, he threw him to the ground. Sohrab had not the strength. His time had come. Rostam was sure he'd not stay down for long. He swiftly drew a dagger from his belt and tore the breast of that stout-hearted youth. He writhed upon the ground, groaned once aloud. My father will avenge my death on you. A hero from among this noble band will take this seed and show it to Rostam. Sohrab's been slain. This happened while he searched for you. When he heard this, Rostam was near to fainting. The world around grew dark with his eyes. This is the way of fortune's wheel. It holds a lasso in this hand, a crown in that. As one sits happily upon his throne, a loop of rope will snatch him from his place. Why is it we should hold the world so dear? We and our fellows must soon travel on. The longer we have thought about our wealth, the sooner we must face that earthy door. If heaven's wheel knows anything of this, or if its mind is empty of our fate, the turning of the wheel it cannot know, nor can it understand the reason why. One must lament that he should leave this world. Yet, what this means, at last, I do not know.
Hello.